Hey guys, this is Anna with another Figma tip. So today I want to talk about how you can use auto layout to build a range slider. In this first example here, I have auto layout already set up, so I can click into the slider component, adjust the left side padding to change the placement of my selection, and then I can click in once again, adjust the space between in order to change the range of the selection. Because this is already built into the component, and I don't have to detach it, I'm able to also change between my different variants that I have set up while still keeping these configurations. In this example below where I did not use auto layout, you'll notice that when I click into the layers, I'm not really actually able to change the placement of the nested frames. So I actually need to detach that instance, and then click in from there and make the adjustments manually. But the downside, of course, is that I won't be able to switch between my different variants, and it's just kind of like a bit more finicky. So I'm going to show you guys how to approach building the first example that I have here. So going to the right here, I already have kind of my basic pieces, which I've created using my handle component. We've got an active track and an inactive track. So first of all, in order to adjust the selected range, I'm going to select the active track and apply auto layout to it. You're going to notice it's going to space things out. And what we're going to do is first select the bar here, and let's make that absolute position. And let's move it so that it properly aligns with the handles. So I'm going to resize it. And we're going to set up this constraints to left and right. So this way, when we adjust the auto layout space between settings and the frame grows as a result, the slider track is also going to grow as well. Okay, so we're able to use the space between to adjust the selected range, but now we want to be able to adjust where within the entire slider component that range falls. To do that, let's click on the entire component and apply auto layout. Once again, for the track, we're going to set that to absolute position and let's move it down so that it is properly aligned. And let's also make sure that we are resizing it down and once again set the constraint to left and right. So this way, when we resize the slider component, you'll notice that the inactive track is also going to resize accordingly. And now that we have auto layout applied, I can go to the left padding and adjust that in order to set the placement of the range slider selection. So once again, using the left padding to set its positioning, and then clicking into the active track and using the space between to set the range of its selection. All right, so that's basically it. I will share an example in Figma community so you can dive into this example deeper, but I hope this was helpful.